Hi everyone, in the previous video we have seen while loop and today we are going to learn do-while. Do-while loop iterates particular part of program several times depending upon the condition. Syntax of do-while can be expressed as do statement while expression. Do-while evaluates expression which must return a boolean value. The major difference between do-while and while is that do-while evaluates its expression at the bottom of the loop instead of top. Therefore, the statements within the loop block are always executed at least once. Do-while is useful when you don't know how many times loop gets executed and you want to run statements within the body of the loop at least once. Do-while is exit control loop because of condition evaluation at last, while previous to for and while are entry control loop because of condition evaluation at the beginning. Flowchart of do-while loop is depicted in this picture. As you can see, statements appears before the condition and after statement compiler checks for the condition. If condition evaluates to true, then compiler will go this way and makes a cycle between statement and condition and repeats this cycle until compiler finds some false condition. If condition evaluates to false, then compiler simply breaks the loop and move forward. Let's see an example of do-while loop. First of all, integer I is equals to 1, then do keyword, then compiler simply prints I's value, then increments I's value by 1, then while I not equal to 3, and don't forget about semicolon. Let's see execution flow. First of all, compiler sets I with 1, then enters in the loop block, simply prints 1 because I has 1 as a value, then increments I by 1. Now I will have 2 as a value, then checks for the condition. 2 not equal to 3, condition is true, compiler makes a cycle. Again compiler prints I's value, but this time it prints 2, then increments I's value by 1. Now I will have 3 as a value, 3 not equal to 3, condition is false and compiler simply breaks the loop and move forward. Output of this program is simply 1 and 2. In the next video, we will see enhanced for loop, an example of all the loops. Until then, this is Vishnu Radhanpura signing off. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe us. Please press the bell icon for latest updates. If you have any doubt about the video, you can ask me on the comment section. Goodbye.